So we're here in the beautiful Grenoble. You're the founder of Blackfoot. So tell me, what is Blackfoot?
Blackfoot, what we want to create is a new way to connect customers to restaurants to have food delivered. We want to reinvent the food delivery industry.
And why is that necessary?
Okay, so basically when we look at the situation right now, we see companies that have created a new way to order food that is very much more convenient for people. But we don't like the way the exchanges happen in these platforms. We don't like the way the wealth is not redistributed to the actual actors of this sharing economy. The value creators we believe are the restaurants and the couriers, and so they should be entitled to reap more benefits from the exchange.
And how are you going to make it happen?
So basically what we want to create is a decentralized food ordering and delivery platform, and we want to use the blockchain as a mean to reduce the importance of the intermediary, to the importance of the third party, and make sure that the value is directly distributed from the customers to the actual creators of value, the restaurants and the couriers.
And how did you came to the idea?
It was during last year. I've watched two things happen in the same time. I saw the rise of the crypto tide, an amazing new way of financing organizations throughout the world with an amazing way of reaching people all around the world to fund your project. And in the same time, I looked at the growing dissatisfaction of service providers of the sharing economy. And I thought, could we create something better using these funding mechanisms, using an altruistic approach?
And then you get the idea. And what were then your next steps to get to where you are right now?
So yeah, we had this idea last year, and we are building a public offer to be allowed to reach investors from all around the world to fund the idea. So we are currently launching a new pre-sale for our project, which will happen in this first half of the year, and we are getting the project to a better place, making everything, the offer better, creating a stronger incentives for users to join us, create a great community. And so we are on this build of reaching investors, and we are currently more focused on building the community than on actually building the product.
And do you did also some market research with the delivery companies and the restaurants?
We reached a lot of couriers and restaurants, and they all have the same, very encouraging phrase. They tell us, we are waiting for you. Where are you? We need you right now. So we have really great feedback from those communities, the restaurants and the couriers, and it's really amazing for us.
And there are now more people in the world thinking about alternatives for the more extractive models like Deliveroo. What is your unique add value also with the blockchain to this ecosystem?
Well, we are the first and the only currently platform that want to launch on the food delivery market. And we want to use the blockchain, as I said, to redirect the value directly from the customers to the restaurants and couriers. And this is really what differentiates us, is that the blockchain will be used in a concrete use case, and it will make the exchange much more transparent and much more secured than in traditional way of doing things.
And how is the your organization now organized? Are you a cooperative, or how does it look like?
So there has been a lot of debate in our investors and in our team, and we wanted to start as a non-profit organization. So we created an association, a French association. We wanted to get this project working with a non-profit organization, but we are now kind of balanced between reaching investors, which often don't understand that we want to use a non-profit form. So we are moving toward either a limited liability company or a cooperative company. That's not defined yet. We're working on this subject right now.
And so you have many stakeholders in the platform. So so you have the platform itself, you got the restaurants, the couriers. So at what way are you also going to give them a part of your ownership and governance in the platform also on long term?
Well, that's a really interesting question, because we focused on the short-term value, what the customer is paying and how this value is redirected to restaurants and couriers. But we have some feedbacks saying that we should indeed maybe think of a different way of sharing this value. And this may include, we're not sure about it yet, we are thinking about it, of giving the ownership back to the restaurants and the couriers in a token economy that will, well, make this possible. And so we are trying different models and make sure that we are choosing the best model for both the actors and the platform to be altogether successful.
And how I look to you is also like you're kind of a platform as a service organization, to put it in a box. You're providing with the software, with the ecosystem, but in the end, the users, they need to do the magic trick to make it happen. So at what way are you also thinking and also experimenting with how to educate the users also to run a successful local delivery platform based on your infrastructure?
Yeah, so the first step for us in this objective would be to create an MVP, an actual minimum viable product that's actually working in an area. And I think Grenoble would be a great place to start, because this is a great city with great values, and there are a lot of cycling paths, and we have a lot of contacts with restaurants, and that would be a great place to start, and to feel how the service providers are connected to their customers and see how they can themselves promote Blockfood platform, because it will be more profitable for them. So we want to experiment how this can translate, their own gain can translate into the general public, and how this can work. This is one part and one way we want to experiment this. And on the other hand, we must also look at traditional way of marketing and target actual classic media, classic means of reaching the general public and creating something, well, in the classic way.
Yeah, so you're kind of a bridge builder between the current situation and your future ambition.
Yeah, exactly. This is things that we're going to build steps by steps, create experimental things, experiment way of doing things. But we are not fixed on how we're going to do it exactly.
And what are your next steps, like from now to the next 3 months?
Okay, so in the next 3 months, there is two main things that are going to happen. The first thing is that we're going to do an actual demonstration of Blockfood. We're going to create not an MVP, but a demonstration of what it should look like and how it will interact with the Ethereum blockchain. And next to that, we are going to launch a new pre-sale, a new way to collect initial funds for the platform. And this will be a starting point for us to be able to create something bigger and something better for the future. And that's what we are right now.
And what's your final ambition? So let's say we talk again in 5 years. When are you a really happy man?
Well, the day where Blockfood is actually kicking out an actual platform, a current platform from a city, will be a great success for us. So if someday we arrive in a city and we are such a success that couriers and restaurants and consumers, they just stop using other platforms to dedicate their time and money for Blockfood, that would be a great success. You know, this is a huge market, and we believe we have a place for Blockfood all over the world. So our goal is not to remove completely the competition, but it's to create something that has meaning and it is used by customers, couriers, and restaurants. So if we succeed doing this in different countries in the world, it will be a great success in the future.